Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says about Ibrahim alayhi salam, إِنَّ إِبْرَاهِيمَ كَانَ أُمَّةً. Ibrahim alayhi salam was an ummah by himself. He was an entire nation. He was a ummah, as the majority of the Mufassirin have pointed out, which I find phenomenal, that they say that what Ibrahim alayhi salam was able to accomplish, the good that Ibrahim alayhi salam put forth, an entire nation could not put forth. And that's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala called him an ummah. Everything about him was invested towards the da'wah, was invested towards spreading this message. Emotionally, he invested himself into this message. He committed himself to the cause. You know how hurtful it was for him to hear those words from his father? He loved his father. If he didn't love his father, he wouldn't have been making du'a for him the entire time until Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forbade him from doing so. He loved his father. And to have your father reject you that way, to have your people reject you that way. He emotionally invested himself so much into this da'wah, physically invested himself to the point that again, he was going to be killed had Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala not saved him and made the fire bardan wa salama, cool and peaceful upon him. And we all know, I mean, you know, subhanAllah, that statement, sticks and stones may break my bones, but words will never hurt. We all know that's a big lie. Emotional hurt, emotional abuse is much more severe than physical abuse. Right? And that's why, you know, when we were growing up, many of you might have the same understanding that, you know what, growing up, if you did something bad, you really wanted your parents to just hit you, to just get it over with. But the worst moments were when your dad would put you in the corner of your mom and say, I'm disappointed in you. You really let me down. I don't even know what to make out of this. Like, dad, could you just smack me across the face and just get it over with? You know, there's the belt. This is much more painful than that. Right? Because that emotionally hurts you. You know, that really, it beats you down on the inside. And Ibrahim alayhi salam was beat down inside out for this cause. And you know what's amazing? When he leaves Haran to Egypt, he continues the da'wah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us about the person who, the king, the oppressive king, who says to Ibrahim alayhi salam, when Ibrahim alayhi salam says, Rabbi alladhi yuhyi wa yumeet, my Lord is the one who gives life and gives death. And Nimrud says, Ana uhyi wa yumeet, I give life and I give death. How do I give life and I give death? Nimrud said, well, here's a guy that was going to be killed, and I'm going to let him go. And here's a guy that's innocent, I'm going to kill him. See, I give life and I give death too. قال إبراهيم فإن الله يأتي بالشمس من المشرق فأتي بها من المغرب. He said, okay, Allah brings the sun from the east, bring it from the west. فبهت الذي كفر. Right? The disbeliever was baffled. He didn't know what to say. So Ibrahim alayhi continued his da'wah from Haran to Masr to Iraq. Everywhere he went, he was completely, entirely invested in the da'wah to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala calls him by himself a ummah, an entire nation.